Aladdin Creations.
Hello friends, welcome to another video of Aladdin Creations. My name is Kavindu. In our previous videos, we have discussed about how to identify and confirm many bacteria in your laboratory. So today, in this short video, I'm going to discuss with you about another lactose fermenting bacteria, Enterobacter. How to identify in your laboratory. Enterobacter comprised of several species including Enterobacter coliwackii and Enterobacter aeruginase, which are most common. Enterobacter species are widely distributed in nature and are found in soil, water, dairy products, intestinal tract of humans and animals. These species prominently shows lactose ferment colonies similar to Klebsiella, but they are not mucoid. Some species of Enterobacter with K antigen possesses a capsule and its colonies are slightly mucoid. Many Enterobacter species are responsible for mixed infection. Therefore, their significance could be decided based on the clinical background. However, most of the time Enterobacter species are less virulent than Klebsiella. Let's focus on the laboratory diagnosis part of Enterobacter species. Since it belongs to normal flora, the laboratory diagnosis must be run along with strong suggestive clinical background. You have to keep in mind the colonies of Enterobacter resemble to that of Klebsiella, but is still distinguishable since Enterobacter species are motile, none or slightly mucoid and orthonine test positive. Enterobacter species readily grow in ordinary media, fermenting glucose with the production of acid and gas. On blood agar, large colonies resemble to Klebsiella but non-mucoid. On Meconium agar, it show large shiny lactose fermenting colonies. Most colonies have pink centered, colorless periphery without sheen. Gram stain give result of gram negative rods. Oxidase negative. If you perform catalase test, it is positive. At this point, we can direct our diagnosis toward the lactose fermenting coliforms. Most commonly, Escherichia coli, Enterobacter, Klebsiella, Citrobacter species, with the available test result and clinical history. Then you can perform the motility test and it gives positive motility, which excludes Klebsiella species. KIA result AA hydrogen sulfide negative and gas positive. Next, other commonly used biochemical test results can be utilized for further diagnosis. When we consider Simmon citrate agar test positive. Citrobacter species also give positive result, but we can utilize the urease test and hydrogen sulfide production for differentiation. Methylate test negative. Oxidase test positive. Indole test negative. Urease test negative. Ornithine deoxycarboxylase test positive. Always interpretation should be done with panel of strong biochemical test results, depending on one or two biochemicals may mislead you. In addition, we can use some other sugar fermentation test as well. If you talk about antibiotic susceptibility, most of clinical isolates are resistant to ampicillin and first generation cephalosporins, but they may sensitive to second or third generation cephalosporins drugs. Well friends, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and gained some knowledge about how to identify this Enterobacter bacteria at your laboratory. Now you can find this video script from our website www.aladdincreations.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit bell icon to update with more medical about the science and medical related videos like this. Thank you.